Today we're going to cover a Japanese urban legend, and this urban legend is usually known as the female Slender Man. It's a creepy one. Here it is, Hachishaku-sama. Hey humans, it's Hannah. Welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, I do videos on creepy and disturbing things, so if that's also your thing, you may want to subscribe. First of all, thank you to Anonymous Empire for this video idea, because it was a really good one. Let's get into it. Hachishaku-sama is roughly translated in English to 8 feet tall. She's appropriately named, as everybody who says they've seen her in real life says she towers over them at about 8 feet tall. She's always wearing a white dress and a white hat. She never wears shoes. She has long black hair. However, though these particular attributes are always the same from story to story, there are different versions of her actual face. Some people who see her say that she takes on the form of a very old, scary hag. Other people say when they see her face, she's a beautiful, very young woman. The legend has it that when she sees a child that she likes, she'll stalk them for days, weeks, sometimes even months before she abducts them. She steals their soul and then kills them. Yes, she only takes children and she never takes adults. This is because she can imitate adults and sometimes even disguise herself as an adult that the child knows and loves so that it's easier to take them. But before you see her, you'll hear her. She's known to make this sound in a very deep male voice, and she does it all the time over and over. Po po, po po, po 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 po. Basically, once you see her, you're almost certainly screwed. Some people say that there are rituals you can follow in order to not get abducted if you see her that involve very complex praying and visits to priests. However, if you can get away from her, your safest bet is leaving Japan altogether. And you'll never be able to return, because if you ever return, even when you're old and gray, she'll find you immediately. There is one story we have of a child who saw her and survived. A long time ago, Hachishaku-sama was actually captured by local monks in the village, and she was trapped in this abandoned building. The building had 4 religious statues on the north, south, east, and west corners in order to keep her trapped there. These statues were called Jizos. One day, one of the statues fell and broke, so there was a weak spot in this protection around the building, and Hachishaku-sama was able to escape. So here's the story of one boy's encounter with her escape. This 8-year-old boy would visit his grandparents every summer in Japan. They lived in a small village and had a big, beautiful backyard. He was visiting as usual, and his parents went on a day trip while he stayed in with his grandparents. He was playing all by himself in the backyard, and he decided to take a rest in the grass to bask in the sun. Suddenly, he heard a very strange sound coming somewhere from behind him. Po, 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 po. In a deep male voice. The child looks around and sees a straw hat on top of the tall hedges. He realized that that was where the sound was coming from. The hat started to move, and suddenly he could see a face in a gap in the hedges. It was a woman wearing the hat, making the strange sound. She had to be 8 feet tall. The 8-foot tall woman eventually left the boy, and he ran back into the house and eventually told his grandparents what he saw. They instantly start to panic and freak out, knowing exactly what he saw. The boy's grandfather instantly walks out of the room to go make a phone call, and then says he has to go out. He instructs the grandmother to stay with the boy and to not let him out of her sight for even a half of a second. They explain to the little boy that Hachishaku-sama has taken a liking to him, and if they don't act quickly, he will surely be dead soon. What a great thing to say to an 8-year-old. So grandfather leaves, and the little boy learns all about Hachishaku-sama from his grandmother, and she explains that the 8-feet tall woman has been trapped for the last 15 years in the building, but she has recently escaped. The grandfather eventually returns with an old woman named Keisan. Keisan hands the little boy a piece of sacred parchment to hold onto. They lock the little boy in his bedroom with a small Buddha statue, bowls of salt everywhere, and tells him not to let go of the parchment. They tell the little boy that if anything scary happens during the night, he should pray to the Buddha statue. They also tell him he must not leave the room until 7 a.m. the next morning, no matter what. They said that they would not come and get him until then, so if anything happens before, do not leave the room. The boy finally falls asleep for a little bit, and then at 1 a.m. is awoken by his door rattling and somebody knocking on the door and tapping on the window. It's the voice of his grandfather telling the little boy that it's okay to come out and that he can stay with him for the the rest of the night so that the little boy isn't lonely. At first, the little boy is excited to hear his grandfather's voice, but he quickly thinks twice and gets suspicious of whoever's outside the door. The little boy refuses to let whatever's out there in, and the creature starts to get very angry and agitated. So the little boy starts praying furiously to the little Buddha statue. And sure enough, outside the door, he hears Po, 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 Po. Again, the salt in the bowl start to turn black. Obviously, it was Hachishaku-sama trying to lure him out of his room. By morning time, all the salt in his room had turned black, but the boy was safe. And around 7:30, he finally braved it and left the bedroom. His family greeted him, and the boy found out that his family was frantically trying to get other blood relatives into the area during the night. They led the boy into a van, and his blood relatives sat on every side of him to protect him. His relatives are sitting on all sides so that if Hachishaku-sama comes, she will hopefully be confused by who is who and not be able to get to the boy. During the van ride, of course, she returns, taps on the window, and says the Po. Po, 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 again, trying to lure the boy to her. The boy screams and his family can't see her, only the little boy can see her. So he's screaming and the family tells him to shut his eyes as tight as he can. And they manage to get to the airport. He and his parents leave Japan and the boy is safe. He was never able to return, even to visit his dying grandfather years later, and couldn't even attend his grandfather's funeral. Years after grandfather died, his grandmother gave him a call as she was on her deathbed as well. The grandmother invited the little boy back to Japan to see her one more time. The boy, who's now a young adult, asks if she really thinks it's safe for him to return. She tells him that it must be by now. But the boy is not so sure, and after a few minutes of silence, sure enough, over the phone, he hears again, Po, 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 po. So the boy survived because he never, ever, ever returned to Japan. This urban legend is very interesting because the white dress, the long black hair trope is very common in these Japanese horror movies. Think of The Ring and The Grudge. It's also said in Japanese urban legends that female ghosts are usually the ones who are seeking revenge. So we can assume that Hachishaku-sama was some sort of distraught spirit that is not able to go to rest and has to abduct children to avenge her death in some way. Anyway, that is the amazing tale and urban legend of the Hachishaku-sama, also often referred to as the female Slender Man. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Leave this video a like if you haven't already, and thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.